Today, we're going to talk about life after work as you step into retirement and some of the critical things you need to think about, from your investment allocation to where you're going to get money from. How does that impact your taxes? And lastly, what are you going to do as you step into retirement? Hello, I'm Logan DeGraeve, Certified Financial Planner here at Barber Financial Group. And what we're going to talk today about is adjusting to life after retirement. You've worked your whole life and now it's time to enjoy what you've saved for. So what we want to talk about is the biggest thing is, what are you going to do in retirement? And I hope you've thought about these things prior to when you retired. I always recommend about 5 to 10 years out before you retire to say, okay, what do we want to do when we retire? But now it's time to take action on these things. And you know, what we may want to look at is, do we want to front load your retirement? And simply what that may mean is, you know, while we have our health and everything's intact, do we want to maybe spend more on travel the first 3 to 5, 10 years of retirement and making sure that that works in the financial plan? You know, I hope everyone has a long, healthy retirement, but the reality is a lot of times those first 5 to 10 years are those go-go years of retirement. So we want to make sure that we have those, you know, planned for and taken care of. But the other thing that you need to be cognizant of is, what are you going to do for health insurance? So if you retire pre-65, what is the plan? Are you going to go to the marketplace? Do you have COBRA? If you are 65, you know, what are you going to do for Medicare? Making sure that you've done all those things. The other thing with insurance is, you most likely lost your group term insurance, your life insurance. So making sure that you still have the proper amount of life insurance. And you know, what I see often with clients is, you know, maybe you still have too much life insurance because, hey, the mortgage is small and the kids are big now. So maybe it's a good time to review what you've done from an insurance standpoint. The next thing, and one of the most important things as you step into retirement, and once again, you want to start planning for this sooner than later, but where is your money going to come from? And that's a critical piece of this early on in retirement, because you can imagine if you had stepped into retirement in January of 2022, you'd probably be a little concerned about how the portfolio performed and you know, where your money's coming from. So what we always like to do is figure out an income strategy, a plan of, okay, I need $7,000 net on a monthly basis to do the things I want to do, Logan. So where does that come from? Is it a combination of Social Security? What investment accounts does it come from? Do you have a pension? We want to make sure that we have all that laid out, because the first thing that is going to change when you do retire is you actually can begin setting the chessboard for what your taxes will look like. That's really important, is having a proactive, forward-looking tax plan and understanding, okay, if I do these certain things, if I take money from X, Y, and Z account, what does that do to my taxes? How does that impact the taxation of my Social Security, potentially your Medicare premiums? All of these things we want to take into account. But the biggest piece of this is sequencing a return risk of the money that you're spending early on in retirement and the dollars you're actually spending, is making sure those are properly allocated and you're not taking too much risk. Because at the end of the day, the biggest adjustment when you step into retirement is that your money is actually your paycheck now, and we want to make sure we get that right. Another critical decision as you step into retirement here is going to be, what do you have from a debt perspective? Are you going to want to carry a mortgage in retirement? You know, maybe the second home's on the horizon. You know, what's the plan? Are we going to have a mortgage? Are we going to pay the mortgage off? You know, and what does that look like? And, you know, I think it's also a really good time as you're stepping into retirement to, you know, think about what you want to do for the second half of life here in retirement. And I always tell people, anytime there's big life-changing events, you want to go back and kind of redefine what your goals are. No, you don't want to, you know, go stray from the plan, but the reality is, in retirement, every day is a Saturday, and you're going to maybe spend more than you thought you may. As you have more grandkids or the grandkids get older, goals and dreams may change. So it's important that you know, sitting down with your financial planner and really going through and making sure that, hey, look, these are still the things that we thought were important 5 or 10 years ago are still going to be important. It goes hand in hand with reviewing that estate plan. Something I talk about a lot is with my clients is, yes, we've done this estate planning, but sometimes family dynamics change. People may get married. People may get divorced. Your grandkids may come to get older, and you may see what kind of adults they are. And do we want to review or change any of those estate planning things? And, you know, it's also critical that you're reviewing your healthcare directives and powers of attorney and making sure all of those type of things are in place as well. One of the biggest things that you talk about in retirement, that usually goes hand in hand in retirement, is Social Security. And I mentioned this earlier as part of the overall plan, but you want to have a plan for Social Security that complements what you're doing. And what I mean by that is, I often have clients that say, well, Logan, I'm going to take it at 62 because I want the dollars. And while that may be a good strategy for you, you don't want to just jump to that conclusion, because remember, if a spouse is were to pass in retirement, only the highest benefit stays. So where this could be important is looking at that forward-looking stress testing financial plan and saying, you know, if spouse A passes at 80 and the other spouse lives to 95, is the Social Security benefits adequate to make sure that we can sustain that lifetime of income? When you're also sitting down for retirement, it's time to really think about what are the things that we want to accomplish and begin talking about trade-offs. And what I mean by that is, I always tell my clients to shoot for the moon and the stars with what they want to do. But at the end of the day, if they can't do everything, is what is the most important things that we want to focus on? So is it travel? Is it a second home? Is it giving? Whatever it may be, those are important to make sure that you're really going through and really talking about those trade-offs there. As always, you want to make sure that you're still looking at your financial plan quarterly. It's important that you can say, look, what happened in 2022 from a market perspective, is my plan still on track long-term? And what you don't want to ever have to worry about is, if you have these big plans in retirement, can you still do the things you want to do if there is a 5 or 10%, 15% market drop from where we sit today? So those are critical. Lastly, kind of in closing here, is you want to make sure that you know what you want to do before you retire. I said that to start, but I can't stress that enough. I see it too often with my clients of, we made it to this goal, we've retired, and now we really don't know what to do because our working years were such a big part of our identity, or maybe our kids don't live here, our grandkids don't live here, and then we're bored and we may not know what we want to do. So clearly setting out and defining those goals, yes, they're going to change in retirement, but you need to start that process 5 to 10 years out, because at the end of the day, the most precious commodity we all have is time, and we want to make sure, especially early on, we're able to do the things that we want to do. And make sure you have a good financial planner that's able to tell you, yes, you can do these things, or whoa, maybe we need to pump the brakes, you know? Because at the end of the day, there's a few different things that can happen. You know, we may sit down with you and say, look, if you stay on the trajectory and path that you're on today, you're going to leave $3 million behind. I'm making that up. And to some clients, they say, okay, that's great. That's what we want to do. Other clients, they say, heck no, I don't want to leave that much to my kids and grandkids. So there has to be a change there of, okay, well, what are we going to change? Because we can either spend more, we can give more, maybe we can retire sooner. And I use this analogy a lot, but when we know there's going to be a legacy or a lot of money left behind, you know, maybe it's time to start doing some things while you are here and alive with warm hands, where you can see your family enjoy it, your kids, your grandkids, because eventually we know they'll get that money with the cold hands upon passing. So those are the type of things that you want to make sure that you're reviewing as you step into retirement. Hopefully it's a long, fruitful retirement for you, and that's why we're here to help. Thank you for joining us on the educational series today. If you'd like to have a discussion about your retirement planning, please find a link to schedule a meeting, whether that's in the office, virtual, on the phone. We're here to help.